channel World of Vishali. Hope you all are doing good and you all are safe. So my today blog is like something like related to professional. As you can see, today I'm in a professional look as well, just to reflect that topic. So like this like blog will be like mostly in English, and it is something about related to the interview. So like I said, like on Instagram, and I've also mentioned in my bio of a YouTube, like I'm glad to share my knowledge with you, like whatever I've done in a 7 years and how I reached there, like whatever like I have a experience, like I'm glad to share with you guys. So I was thinking, why not to share with you the interview tape. So whenever I like go for the interview, and like what I talk about and how I talk about, and like how I dressed up, and what things I keep in my mind, and what things you should like learn. So like there are so many things. So like this is not a professional full blog, because this is just my experience and like how I like prepare myself for the interview and how I give interview. Maybe this can help you as well, and you can learn some things from this. And you must have read a lot of things on the internet as well. When you like type anything on a Google, like the interview question, how you should be like prepared about that, etc. You will find a lot of blogs, you will find a lot of articles about that, and they are giving so many suggestions to you. So like when I started my career and when I started giving interviews, I never read any blog, I never like look into any points that mention on the internet, because it makes me more complicated, it makes me more confusing. So everything like comes like automatically in my mind, and like when I like sit in front of the HR, in front of the seniors like who take the interviews, then everything comes automatically. Now I can share some things like how I pretend and how I give the interview. So the first thing I would like to start with the dress. So whenever you go to the interview, the very common thing and very important thing is your dress. You should be formal, you should wear a formal clothes, because it gives you the expression that you are serious about the job and you are in a professional world, right? It's nothing if you go casual as well. Nobody asks you. There are like very few people who will ask you about that, but this is not a good good impression, like as per my experience. So if you are going to give a telephonic interview as well, then you should also like dressed up in a formal. So this is the first thing. And the second thing is confident. You should be confident when you are giving the interviews, because it reflects the confidence level as well. And secondly, the people, the HR who is taking interview, they think that you are capable of doing that thing. And when you are confident, they judge you very less, like because they are listening everything that you are talking about, your way of talk and your confident level, what you are talking, everything is matters. And the third thing is English. You know, as of now, like if you are giving interview for the abroad and any country, English should be a must. Like without English, it is difficult to survive. Honestly, I will share my experience. When I started my career, I was zero in the English, and like sometimes like it's like horrible situation for me, as it was horrible situation for me as well. Like I was scared to like talk to the people when it comes to English language, but this improves a lot. I don't say like perfect, but this improves in all like last 7 years, because I'm like working in that English environment. I'm working in the corporate world where you have to talk like in English, you have to do meetings in English, you have to give presentations in English. So when you work and when you sit and when you like on a daily basis, it become your routine, then it start improve. So that's automatically happen. Like if you don't speak English every day, then it will never gonna improve. Like I used to do practice like when I did not start my career, but nothing comes out, no output comes, because this is the thing that you can do only when you are in that environment, and it makes you more confident as well. It does not matter you are speaking right English or wrong English, but you should be confident and you should speak English that other person can understand. Nobody is perfect in this world, right? And Hindi is our like mother tongue, but try to improve your English and speak in English and be confident about that. So the first is dress, second is confidence, the third is English, and the fourth is what you should prepare like before the interview. Like first, which company is taking the interview? You should know about the company profile, what they are doing, what industry is it, what are their services, and within the company you should know the job description that you have applied for. So if I am like applying for the marketing position, then I should know like what job responsibilities they have mentioned in the marketing, because like in my last video I said marketing like is about so many things, but particularly they want in that position, you should read about that before the interview. So third one is like you should be aware about the location and you should be aware about your expected salary. So these three things are important when you start your interview. It is not necessary that you need to tell everything about the company. Sometimes they ask you, but most of the times they tell you what the company is about and what they are expecting from you. It is not only a one communication from your side, it is a communication from both sides equally. So never be scared for the interview, just go with the confidence. And there is a like need to prepare the things, like if it is about the technical interview, you should prepare your own things, the technical part. If it is like about marketing, you should read about, but don't be crazy, don't go crazy like tomorrow is my interview and you are in a rush, you are so tense, you are not sleeping in a night and tomorrow is your interview. Don't take any tension, just be easy and just go. And when you sit over there, when you sit in that environment, everything come automatically in your mind. And honestly, I never spend a lot of time in the interview preparation, because you are already prepared. You have 7 years of experience. When it comes to the experienced candidate, then you have everything in your mind, because 7 years you are doing that thing every day, right? You don't need to do a rectification. You don't need to read that lines again and again just to be a very perfect in the interview. That should be in your mind. That should like everything you know practically, then it will come automatically when you speak. And be friendly in the sense, don't like strict yourself in the limitation while speaking. Be frank. If you have any questions with the interviewer, then you can ask like freely. Don't think like what you have to ask, is this stupid question or what? No, don't think about that. If you will like put so many restrictions on your mind, then you will not going to crack your interview. It will burn you and it will like give you a lot of pressure and you will forget everything. So just like totally free your mind, relax and be easy, and just everything that you have learned in like last years and the experience you have, that's in your mind when you sit, it will come automatically. So now I will give you the example how I give my interview every time. I want to share with you, so maybe it will be helpful for you as well. I will explain step by step. Okay, so first I give my introduction, and in the introduction you don't need to explain everything, your background, your family and blah 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 blah, right? So you just like speak in 2 to 3 lines. If any information is required about your background, like in detail and hobbies and family, they will ask you directly. You don't need to explain in starting because it will spoil your interview and it will take a lot of time to explain about you. So first start with like, for example, my name is Vishali. I am from India and currently I'm staying in a Bangkok and I'm working in a XXX company, right? Then after that it comes to your education. So how you will say, starting with my qualification, I have done my BTech in electronics and communication from Punjab Technical University, India. That's it. No need to go in a details. I have done 12th, I done 10th from this school, etc, etc, etc. No need for that. Even if you are fresh, I don't think so it's required because I never talk about that. Third is like start your career journey. So if I talk about my career journey, there are so many companies in 7 years, and there are reason behind that why I left, that there are so many things to talk about. So just to, if you have so many companies, then just first talk about your skills, what you do exactly, give an overview if you have not changed any profile, and then say the same thing I have done in this. If something is different, then talk about the specific company. But if you have like very less companies, then you can go one by one. First is the current one, then the past companies. So go in that alignment. So if like I will give the interview because I worked in so many companies, and it's very difficult to explain in a very limited time because the interview will give you like hardly 30 minutes, 45 minutes or 1 hour. These 3 times like mainly they keep for the interview. When you have a 30 minute, then what you will do? If you will explain your 7 to 8 companies, then the whole interview will finish in this only. Then how you will start? I'm working as a head of marketing in XXX company, and I have like experience into digital marketing profile, and I worked in the multiple industry XXXXX, and I'm like looking after all the social media marketing, including the Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn and Twitter, and I'm doing all the SEO strategy. I'm running a campaigns, the Google AdWords campaigns and the Facebook ads, etc. And also I'm looking after the content marketing and the PR and the influencer, and also working with the development team, and I'm giving a recommendation to them so they can implement on the website, and I'm analyzing the data and making the reports and giving the overview. So like this you can explain like about your current company, and you can say in the past company is like, in the past company I was doing the same, and also I was like analyzing and making the reports, and I was doing the invoices, there I was writing the content as well. There was no team, so I was the only person who was writing the content for everything. I'm not a professional content writer, but I used to curate the content. So I also worked in a development team, like whenever is required, because sometimes you have to be a versatile, you have to do a lot of things. If you are hired for the marketing, then it does not mean you have to do marketing only, you have to do a lot of things as well. So just give an overview, and for the past company, just a specific keyword that you want to highlight, and as per the JD that they want to listen. So give the overview, and in the end just say, this was the overall experience I had, and it was a very great journey. I learned so many things in many companies, everywhere I learned something different, and that's all. And then they will ask you the general question, like first they will like start, okay, have you handled the team? If you are at a manager position, if you are a head of the marketing, then how many member you have handled in your past? Then talk about that, like how many team member you have handled, that's it. And second question they will ask you, like is there any challenge that you have faced in your job? So challenge is like there are multiple projects, for example, okay? You are working in a marketing, but there are multiple projects the company has given to you for marketing, for analytics, and for the accounting, for the campaign, and for the development. Then then it is a challenging for you, right? How you will manage everything in 8 hours job? You have to be maybe work overtime. So tell about that capabilities that you can do a multitasking as well. So like brief them about that. And you must have like read about the strength and weakness on the internet. Don't care about that, because like I never mention about my strength, my hobbies, my weakness since I started my career. I started my career in 2014 and I never talked about my strength, weakness, and nobody asked me. Why they will ask you? They will ask you in some other manner. Like I said, have you faced any challenge, right? Is there any pain point of you? Is there any pain point that you have like faced in a project and all? So they will ask you indirectly, but nobody will say what is your strength and what is your weakness, etc. and all. And other question that you can ask you, like are you comfortable with this location? Say yes, that you like, you should aware about that before the interview and you should be prepared. And they will talk about your expected salary. Like in every interview they will ask you for the expected salary. So for the expected salary, when it comes to me, when I'm staying in the same country and my like the basic salary and like how it hike will go, then I just like maintain the 15%, the 30% hike like that. When you change the country, you don't know about the cost of living. So it happens 2 times with me, when I relocated from Delhi to Mumbai. So I was not aware about the cost of living in Mumbai. Then I said, I'm not aware. Whatever you will give, I believe so, it will be like good for me. So just wait for their answer, wait for their decision, what salary they will give to you. If you feel this is not something that will work for you, then talk about that. And second is Bangkok, the same. I was not aware what is the cost of living in Bangkok. So if I say something less and they are going to be give me a high, then it will be like, you know, messed up. So don't say anything when you are changing a country and changing a city and state when you are not aware about the cost of living of that place. Talk about that in like after the interview, later on. So you will get a lot of time for the discussion because interview process is too long. There is another question as well that most of the interviewers asked, that is like how like are you comfortable to work in a team? They ask this question because it is a corporate world and there are a lot of like professionalism and the politics and how you handle that situation. So you should be like very smart in that. And if you are working in a team, you should be very polite with everyone. You should like work in a group. And if you have any views, any opinions, don't apply. First discuss with your team. So say positive about that. And of course, whenever you are doing anything, any task, and you require a team, you require a support, you alone can't like work and grow your company. If you are even like individual, then well and good, but if you're working in a team, then you have to be, everyone have to be go like this. You can't go like this and other people are coming one and one. No, you all have to be go like this. So there are a lot of things that you need to be think, and there are a lot of things that you should like care about like before speaking. There are a lot of things that you need to think before speaking, so must remember. And then they will finish up with this HR round. They will like prepare your second round, and in the second round is more about the technical. They will ask you so many techie questions with related to your profile. Again, be easy, be relax, nothing is gonna happen in the interview. So if everything is in your mind, you are talented, you know everything, you like have done everything practically, nobody like can shoot you, nobody. So and your smile is very very important in the interview, the way you talk, your English, your confidence, your dress up, and your answers smartly. And please don't confuse with the internet questions answers. If you want, you can take this as a reference, just go through it just to make your mind like, oh, you know, like when you read something and something come, then it will start working, right? So, but it is not required. I never prepare. I never. And I just speak on the flow. And if this position and this company is good for you and you have given your best, then you will be hired. If it is not perfect for you, believe me, like this thing may be not a professional. I believe on God, right? So whatever will happen with you, that will be good. So if you will not get hired, that means another good opportunity is waiting for you, and that can be a good than this, right? So just keep on giving your interviews and don't give up, and wait for the right opportunity, wait for the right place, wait for the right profile. Keep on applying on LinkedIn and in the India, the Naukri.com. So whenever like I got a job in India, I always go through the Naukri.com. I did not get any job through the reference. And in Bangkok, I used to apply on a LinkedIn. So LinkedIn is the platform, international platform, where you will get the message, emails and calls for the job interviews for the international companies, for the international countries. So this is the only platform. There are the local platform as well, but LinkedIn is one of the common that everyone is using. So कोई रॉकेट साइंस नहीं है इसमें, कुछ भी नहीं है, कोई डर वाली बात नहीं है. जस्ट इजी होके अपना इंटरव्यू दीजिए, और ये खौफ बिल्कुल रखना ही नहीं है कि आज मेरा इंटरव्यू है हाई कैसा होगा. नर्वस तो होना ही नहीं है. दिस इज जस्ट लाइक इंटरव्यू आप सामने वाले को दे रहे हो, जो वो भी एक ह्यूमन ही है, ठीक है, वो भी आपकी तरह इंटरव्यूज देके आया ही है. बट ये कि यू हैव टू बी बिहेव प्रोफेशनल, तो आप थोड़ा उसको देख के नर्वस हो जाते हो. बट इंटरव्यू इज नथिंग, इट इज़ नॉट अ रॉकेट साइंस. ये कोई ऐसी चीज़ नहीं जो तुमको खा जाएगी और तुमको लाइक इतना डर क्यों लगता है. मुझे भी लगता था, लेकिन मैं आपको एक्सपीरियंस शेयर कर रही हूँ. स्टार्टिंग में मुझे भी लगता था, बट आप जब एक दो इंटरव्यू दे देते हो ना, तो वो जो कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल आ जाता है ना, उससे आपकी जो झिझक है ना, वो खुल जाती है. और आप जब फ्रीली इंटरव्यू दोगे ना, तो सामने वाला आपसे ज़्यादा इम्प्रेस होता है. और अगर आपने अच्छा इंटरव्यू दिया फिर भी आप सिलेक्ट नहीं हुए, तो इट डज़ नॉट मीन यू वर रॉन्ग, इट डज़ नॉट मीन यू लाइक वर डम और आपको कुछ आता नहीं, ऐसा नहीं, ऐसा बिल्कुल भी नहीं है. ये सोचना कि वो अपॉर्चुनिटी आपके लिए सही नहीं है. अगेन, यू आर ऑलवेज राइट. यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग योर सेल्फ 100%, यू आर गिविंग योर 100%. बट इफ it does not happen, it does not mean it is your mistake. It means this is not a right place for you, this is not a right opportunity for you. You have a good opportunity which is waiting for you. So just be patient and stay focused and always be motivated and keep hunting for a jobs, and one day you will be successful, and keep on going like this. So that's all about the interview. It was very basic. Just I shared my experience, and if I will give the interview now, then it will be like so many things, and most of the thing you will not understand. Some things I have already explained, like in my last blog, what is my job and profession, which is similar. So yes, if I said anything wrong, just sorry for that in advance. I'm not sure, but I just shared my experience. I have no intention to say anything wrong about anyone. I just shared my experience only. And if this video is like helpful for you, that would be a good moment for me that it helped you. And thank you so much for watching it. And that's all. And मैं ये ब्लॉग यहीं पे एंड करती हूँ. एंड स्टे सेफ, स्टे हेल्दी, स्टे हैप्पी. वी सी यू इन अ नेक्स्ट ब्लॉग. तब तक बाय बाय, लव यू.